So what is a makerspace and why does it matter to the educational community? We've all heard the stories and we've seen it in our classrooms. Things are getting stale. Classrooms are filled with bubble tests, accountability, state standards, where we're trying to get everyone to be the same. We're trying to get everyone to fit into the same mold. That's the wrong direction we need to be taking. Our problems are bigger than that. Makerspaces help produce students that can think and solve problems. I'm Will McCoy, the CEO of EdTech Authority, where we bridge the gap for technology in schools. So there's a buzz around makerspaces, and rightfully so. Makerspaces are amazing places on school campuses that need the attention of administrators, need the attention of teachers, and really need to be special places incorporated onto your school campuses. So what is a makerspace? Think of it as a combination of what used to be considered woodshop and art class and the computer lab. Put all of those things together and add 3D printers, laser cutters, and building materials all over the place. If you can picture that in your head, you kind of have an idea of what a makerspace is. So let me explain an example of one that I helped build. We put together a makerspace that had a large area for building full of building materials. It had work tables and sawhorses and saws and hammers and nails. So there was that portion. Then over to the side, there was a computer lab where students learned how to code and they learned how to build apps in the computer lab. There was also a digital design studio where they did all sorts of amazing things with graphic design, engineering, CAD drafting, all in a separate area specifically designed for that because you don't want your dust from your building area getting into your computers. And then finally, there was a TV studio with a green screen where students could produce videos and newscasts and opinion pieces and broadcast those onto YouTube. Makerspaces are vibrant learning spaces, and they're greatly needed in this age of accountability and testing. They need to counterbalance the stagnation that we're seeing in our classrooms with the real world application of exploration and creativity and invention. The best maker spaces help students solve problems, and they can be open-ended problems. You may not know how to catapult a tinfoil ball across a room and into a bucket, and the students may not know how to either. What's important is you provide them with the opportunity and the resources to try and figure it out. And they may be able to do it and they may not. But isn't that the real world? Isn't that what work is about? It's about having a big, hairy problem that you have to try and get after, using your resources, and then trying to solve that problem. That's what good makerspaces do. They ask kids to solve problems, apply knowledge, learn together, collaborate, and work toward solutions for problems that we may or may not have solutions to. Let's not forget that students love makerspaces. They love getting in and learning. There are no passive learners in a makerspace. You have to be up, you have to be busy. If you are sitting, you're not active, you're not learning. And if we're holding kids accountable for learning, we get them all busy. But frankly, I've never seen a kid just want to sit in a makerspace. They want to get involved. It feels more like fun, engagement, play, but there are critical ideas that are being taught. Analysis, problem solving, solution finding, collaboration, all skills that are not only important in the classroom and in the makerspace, but in the broader context as citizens. Don't you want to work with someone that knows how to attack a problem and help solve it? That can communicate their ideas, can analyze a problem, and then come to a solution together? Makerspaces mimic the real world and the real world of work. That's one of the reasons they're so critically important. So makerspaces teach kids about learning in the real world and application and problem solving. Critical skills that we would want any person in society to have. Much more important to be able to learn to solve a problem in the real world than to fill in a bubble on a bubble test. Makerspaces are critically important to a society where we look at not just regurgitation of information, but creation of new information and invention. We are an invention society, and makerspaces help plant those seeds so that every kid, boy, girl, whomever, from whatever background, can contribute to that conversation and solve problems. So what really gets built in makerspaces are future citizens and problem solvers. We're giving students what they need, which is what our society needs as well. If you get the chance, you should go out and visit a makerspace. They're popping up everywhere, and hopefully they're popping up in your school. This has been Will McCoy. I welcome your questions and comments below. Have a great day.